cousins. Their son, Prince Titus, seeks a bride. A festival will take place this very evening. As I speak, invitations are being delivered to the homes of carefully selected young maidens. The charming Prince Titus will choose this evening one of those maidens to be his bride and future queen of Agricole. Let the preparations begin. Delaney! Where is Prince Titus? You were supposed to be keeping an eye on him for the festival tonight.
Mr. Prince Titus knows the festival tonight, but he's going to help a farmer, sir. A farmer in danger of losing his crop.
Run, bring the prince home. The festival announcement has been made.
Missy, he already knows, but he won't leave a farmer in need, ever.
Bring him now. The prince must elect a bride tonight if he wishes to become king. Our people need a leader.
I will do that, for my people need him as a leader, too.
I want to see you in 2 hours' time with the prince in tow.
I won't fail you, Missy.
Delaney, that's the wrong way.
I know.
My darling, you're my king and I'm your queen, but how can you say Prince Titus is wrong?
My queen? Our son will be 30 years old in 2 days. The law states that the prince must marry before his 30th birthday. If he does not select a bride within 2 days, we will be without a king.
Titus knows that, dear. He will attend the festival tonight.
Will he? Or will he take this opportunity to disappear? To play another one of them practical jokes? You know how Prince Titus likes to play tricks.
You know, the royal farm is at stake, and Titus, he would never, ever risk losing that royal farm. It's going to bring prosperity back to Agricole.
My queen, Prince Titus must learn to obey the laws before he earns the right to change them.
I know that, dear. I have sent out the invitations, and I have done everything that I can to rush Titus along.
Well, we've been rushing along for years and years, and just this past week we convinced him to wear shoes. Why won't he wear shoes?
He must be connected with Earth, because that's the way of our people, and Titus, he understands them. That's why he's going to make a fine king.
Well, then let us pray he'll claim his throne before it's too late.
Together we serve.
Together,
we will find a way.
My queen.
My king.
Oh, shit.
Titus, my dear son, you must find a bride tonight. We cannot, we must not fail our people.
We fail our people if these men lose their crops, Delaney. I will not.
Titus, in 2 days you'll be 30. If you do not find a bride and marry her, you will not become king.
And without my help, these people lose their entire crop for the year. They have no money, no food, and no trust in me.
Prince Titus, when you become king, you can establish the royal farmland and give your people the help they need. It's only 2 days.
I will hear no more.
I found a pumpkin farmer, sir.
You what?
I found your secret pumpkin farmer.
Delaney, are you giving me the runaround?
I would not play a joke about something so integral to your success.
Your Majesty.
The secret farmer? This is wonderful news. Did you know this farm is, grows pumpkins that have magical healing abilities?
You need those pumpkins, sir. Your people need them. Go see your pumpkin farmer. Convince him to join your royal farmer.
Thank you, Delaney.
I have one condition.
Anything.
You must attend the festival tonight. Unless you make a binding promise, I will not tell you the whereabouts of your...
Delaney!
You must find a bride tonight. Only then can you create the royal farmland and save your people.
All right, Delaney, I'll attend the festival.
No. I said a binding promise. One you cannot break, even if you wish. Seal it, sir.
I promise to attend the festival of marriage on the eve of this very day and to find a bride.
Finish it.
If I do not, I will be banished to live
Among the Ungreen.
The Ungreen, sir? Forced to live forever among those that do not honor the earth? A more binding promise I have never heard, my prince.
Thank you. Now, tell me, where does the pumpkin farmer live? Right.
Follow the river north
until
you meet the fork, and then east over the three hills. The pumpkins are grown on a farm known as Puerto de Mer.
Puerto de Mer. I shall return tonight.
Godspeed, sir.
You must fight for your chance, Cinderella. Fight like
I do not wish to be queen, Papa. My place is here.
The king and queen have by the means of this home.
I saw the invitation, Papa. My name is not on it.
Now, how did you see this?
My stepsisters, Papa, Piper and Mandolin. They came to me straight away after receiving that little invitation of theirs and showed me clearly how beautiful their names were written, Papa, and how mine was absent.
Are you going to let that stop you? Where's my bold daughter? You should want more for yourself, Cinderella.
I want to live here, Papa, tending this patch of mamas.
Your mother loved these pumpkins, Cinderella, but she loved you more. You should honor your mother's memory and attend the festival.
I am not a festival girl, Papa. I've not been, and I'm not going to change now.
You sound like your mother. Don't waste your life out here as I fear she did.
She did not waste her life, Papa. She taught countless farmers how to coax their crops into fruit. She healed them with all these pumpkins.
Yes, she did, but she cannot heal herself.
Papa, let my stepsisters attend the festival. Wearing fancy dresses and shoes on their feet. Like Mama, my place is here, with my feet on the earth.
Very well, Cinderella. Stay here. One day the world's going to ask you to share your gifts, and even your pumpkins will give you no place to hide.
Well, Mama, but a life without my pumpkins is not a life I wish to live. I cannot, I must not fail these people that depend on me. Hello, John! My tiny mouse, you are so early today. Look at you, just being so cute with your little ears and everything and this little hat. What are you doing? That's him. You can't just blame him. I bet it was the cat. Oh, good day, Henry. Oh, yes, I suppose you are right. We should get to work, shouldn't we? My pumpkins are the only thing I understand. Oh, my gosh, look at you. You're even cuter today. Oh, my gosh. Oh, and Buttercup, you got the seeds. Oh, my goodness, right over here. Tend the soil. Harvest the grain. To keep every day from being the same. While my hands have loved you every day since birth. While my feet stay planted firmly on the earth. Oh my gosh, Beatrice, I'm gonna get you today. Are you gonna help me? Come on, let's go. Oh, not too far, too far. Oh, too far again. Oh, Beatrice, come on. Well, come on, Buttercup, help me. You're supposed to be the fun one around here. Go get her, come on. Oh, too far. Okay, when she comes out, one, two, three. We're gonna get her. Ready? One, two, three. Oh, that was too slow. Go ahead. Go. Well, you guys were such a great help. Well, come on. Okay, you do this, please. No. Oh, well, now where are you guys going?
My God.
That's a nice one, isn't it?
Yeah, yes, it is. Well, it is beautiful.
Interested in our pumpkins, huh?
Yes! Excuse me, I've been terribly rude. I seem to be in a trance.
Well, they do have a bit of magic about them, and I really do thank you for your interest, but we're not selling them for another month or so, so come back.
Well, I do not wish to buy them, maiden. I wish to speak to the man who grows them.
That's impossible. The farmer up this land is a hermit. No one ever speaks to him or sees him or anything, really.
Oh, well, yes, and I am here demanding to speak to him.
You are demanding?
Yes.
Come back next month.
Well, at least do me the honor of passing along your message. I do not have much time.
Very well. I'll hear and decide if this message is worthy of passing along.
The royal family is by request of the prince, starting a royal farmland to be run by the greatest farmers across Agricole. I am here to extend an invitation to the secret farmer to come and work with us.
And we citizens are supposed to believe this? That prince should start worrying about finding a bride.
The festival of marriage is tonight.
Oh, yeah. Instead of playing pretend with a bunch of farmers.
Well, if you would just listen.
Who all think he's a joke anyway?
A joke?
He's days away from his 30th birthday and he refuses to choose a bride. We all know the law, sir.
Maiden, I wish to speak to the farmer of this land.
For the last time. No.
These perfect pumpkins don't grow by magic alone.
No, not by magic alone. Mostly hard work with the bare hands and something I assure you our prince does not understand.
How are you sure that I am not he?
You wear no shoes. You belong to land. Of course you're one of us.
Indeed, I despise wearing shoes.
I never wear shoes. Farmer must know the ground and memorize the feeling of the earth
under his feet. The simple connection helps us know where our life is rooted.
I wish our prince knew that.
Might I buy just one of these pumpkins? Surely you can spare just one.
My pumpkins are not for sale, sir. End of discussion.
Forgive me, maiden. Did you say your pumpkins?
This is my pumpkin. You think you can touch me? Oh, you think you can...
Well, we tried desperately for you to choose a bride. Where do I find you? In the arms of a milkmaid.
Oh, Stephanie, please.
The lady may take you at your word, and I will stay by your side until you set foot into the castle. Hop to you, Titus.
It does!
Titus?
As in the currently not-so-charming Prince of Agricole? Full of surprises, our young prince. Now move your unshod feet, boy.
Stephanie, please. Put it down. Okay. You must be the most secret farmer in our land. The one I've been searching for these last few months.
Oh, a pleasure, ma'am.
Will you come to the festival this evening? I will tell you my dreams of establishing the royal farmland.
I've not been invited by the king or queen. It would be very rude.
I am the future king. Please, I will stand here until you give your consent.
You most certainly will not. Sir, you are the prince of Agricole. You shall find other pumpkins.
Other pumpkins will not suffice.
The time is growing near, my prince. We must go now.
Maiden, my fate is in your hands.
I'll go to the festival tonight. My bare feet and all.
You have your secret farmer. Now let us find a proper ride for you. Come.
Indeed, I too have a binding promise to keep. Farewell, maiden. We shall meet tonight. Good sir. Are you the father of this house?
I am.
Okay. Oh, thank you. This is an invitation for the farmer girl over there, yes? It bears the official seal of the King of Agricole and should thereby be treated as a command. Good day.
Goodbye. Cinderella! Cinderella!
You him?
Cinderella! A man delivered this just a moment ago, a personal invitation to the Prince's Festival. Now, I know you do not wish to attend, but how can you refuse now?
An invitation? Only for me? And on the King's stationery?
Cinderella, my dear, you have been chosen to attend. You must forget your objections.
I'll go, Papa. In honor of Mama and everything I hold dear to her, I'll go, Papa, and I'll win that prince's heart.
And now, Cinderella.
Oh, but Papa, there's not going to be anyone like me there. I'm going to win that prince's heart with all the soil under my nails and the bare feet and all and everything.
There will be many.
Oh, but none like me, Papa. None who understand his love for the earth and everything. I must go now, Papa. Time is short.
Your spirit survived, my love, on this land you love and in the soul of our daughter. Be with our child. Shower her with your magic, for I am unfit to do so.
Pumpkins.
Do you know what the villagers say about her pumpkins?
What?
They think her ugly gourds have healing powers. Even have a festival to celebrate the secret farmer.
I don't get it.
They call her the secret farmer because
she... Oh, because she's the farmer!
Are y'all what? Done.
Mother.
No, that's my son.
No, stop. Get away. Get away.
I trust that since you have found time for playing, you have picked out your gowns for the evening?
No, Mother. Everything is too plain. We should have new dresses for a day, such as this.
Yeah, Mom.
How can you expect the prince to choose me?
Hush, child. Cinderella!
Yes, stepmother? Go and fetch the boxes from my chest.
Your chest of precious clothing, stepmother?
Must I repeat myself, Cinderella?
I'll return straight away.
She heard us call her. Next time I'm gonna get her.
Quiet. We only have a moment to discuss.
We don't have to protect her dear heart, Mother. We were invited to the festival and she wasn't simple without me.
How is it that neither of my daughters know when to shut up and listen to me?
What are you so worked up about, Mother?
She's gonna have another episode. Remember, it starts in her toes and we go, oh,
God, God, you're like,
what in the world is this?
Cinderella's personal invitation to the festival. Your daft father did not even realize the prince himself was the messenger. He delivered it himself.
To Farmerella.
Yes, and if she is receiving a personal invitation, we can't allow her to go tonight. She would be far too much of a distraction.
But if she got a real invitation from the prince, shouldn't she go?
Do you want to watch the prince follow Farmerella around all evening while you are left to dance with no one?
Tell that stopper, Mother.
What should we do?
We shall convince her that the prince likes to play jokes at these sorts of things, festivals and other important events, to entertain himself. We'll tell her that we received a surprise note with our invitation promising a guest sure to bring laughter to the party.
We're gonna bring Farmerella.
Farmerella! Yes! Now, not another word.
Okay.
Cinderella!
Not always words.
Where is she?
Where'd she go?
We don't have until midnight! Now remember what I said, girls. You cannot wait to see the look on her face when he pulls a trick on some unsuspecting person.
Okay. Too far. You must be pulling a trick on me.
Why does he pull a trick on me?
Cinderella?
I mean that these boxes are way too heavy for clothing. You must have weighed that with something.
Oh, silly girl. You're just so used to your farming things that you've forgotten the weight that beauty holds. Fabric fit for a royal festival is rich and heavy.
I suppose. May I go now, stepmother? I have to prepare myself.
No, dear. We need your help trying on dresses. I should think that you would want to stay and help your sisters.
Of course, stepmother, but only I've been invited myself.
May we open the boxes, mother? Yeah, I'm dying to see what I shall wear to meet the prince tonight. Because we're going to dance and dance and dance.
Madeline, dear, what have I told you? Fewer words leave at least something to the imagination.
Okay. Oh, no, I want one. No, oh,
I want
my ravishing. He shall fall in love with me the moment I walk into the room.
He will pass by every maiden.
Not everyone.
Stepmother, can I go? I have to find a dress.
Well, no, Cinderella. We need your help.
Put this on me.
Okay.
No, put it on me.
Oh, you put them on me.
Oh, my God.
I should think that the prince would choose someone from the country this time for his little trip. I mean, he's been spending so much time out here lately.
Stepmother.
Maybe it will be some poor farm girl thinking that she has a chance with the prince.
I wonder what the invitation even looks like, Mother.
Probably scribbled on a piece of paper. The king and queen couldn't even know about it.
Know what?
Farmerella doesn't know.
He was gonna...
Well, you received a real invitation, so it wouldn't matter, would it? I'm sure everything is fine and there's nothing to worry about, dear. You did receive the note about the special surprise guest, right?
No, I don't think so.
You did not receive the note about the special surprise guest?
He was gonna play a trick on... Oh, we just couldn't. No.
Oh. Cinderella, the prince likes to play tricks at these sorts of things. Festivals and other important events to entertain himself. He is notorious for bringing someone of whom his parents would not approve in order to ruffle their feathers.
Well, what does that have to do with me? I actually know him.
You got a handwritten note that only the prince knows about.
We just didn't want you to humiliate yourself. Mm-hmm. The last girl he invited, she went crazy. Mm-hmm. She was banned forever and ever and ever and ever.
It is a cruel trick, Cinderella, and I won't allow you to endure it. I'm only glad that we found out about it before it was too late.
I cannot believe he would do this to me.
He is called the Charming Prince Titus for a reason. You're the first one to fall into his little trap.
I need a moment alone.
Clean that up, darn it, okay? Now that we've confused her, we shall keep her busy. Even if she changes her mind, she'll have no time to prepare for the festival. Now, run along, girls. You have a prince to win tonight. That's me. Come, Cinderella. Some hard work will get your mind off of your broken heart.
Oh, thank you, stepmother. I was so confused.
I know, dear, but that's why I'm here to guide you, Cinderella, and steer you away from things that would make so many of us so unhappy. Come! Oh.
She's smart and caring and willing to sacrifice for her people. I must get her to join us.
Son, are we still talking about this secret farmer girl?
Yes, Father. I invited her to the festival this evening.
Titus! I'm not going to allow you to spend the entire evening with some nasty farm girl.
Some farm girl? Mother, she's the greatest farmer in our land.
That may be true, Titus, but that does not make her a suitable companion for the Prince of Agricole.
Olivia.
Titus, I've
let you have your way for far too long. Now, tonight, you are going to spend the entire evening dancing with young maidens who are suitable to become queen.
Tonight is my only opportunity to convince the farmer to join in our cause. I will not sacrifice this opportunity because you do not approve, Mother.
Titus?
I'm the future king of Agricole. What would the king do?
Oh, aha! You must convince the farmer, Titus.
Thank you.
And you must select a bride.
Titus, selecting a bride is not only to fulfill an ancient obligation. How is a king supposed to love his people if he has no true love in his own life?
Love?
Yes, Titus, you want to take on the world. In order to take on such a big challenge, a king must surround himself with love.
Surround myself with love.
With your love beside you.
Come, come.
There is no doubt that your secret farmland or your royal farmland will be a reality.
I shall look with an open heart, my king, my queen. Now, if you excuse me, I must prepare. I must wear shoes this evening if I'm to find a bride.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Oh, gosh.
My lovely wife, queen of my heart, would you escort an old man to the festival tonight?
My king, I will take my place by your side as we watch our son make his way to the throne. Perfect. Did you see the way Farmer Ella wilted? And Mother there to hold her, pretending to comfort her.
Did she actually think that a prince would fall in love with a dirty, plain farmer girl?
She knew exactly where to hit Cinderella. Her pride will allow him to make a fool of her.
The perfect lie.
Of course, I do dearly wish I could have seen her attempt manners at the festival and the dancing. I should have loved to see her try to dance.
Can you imagine those filthy hands touching a prince?
He should really thank us for saving him from such an embarrassment, inviting a stinky girl to ruin the party. I mean, it's no wonder her mother died so early. Would you want to raise such an ugly thing?
Mommy! Mommy!
Sure, Cinderella!
Mommy! Mommy! Teach me how to barb!
Go away, Cinderella! I don't want you, Cinderella! No one wants you!
Oh, my goodness. That's some rude.
I'm not ready. Oh, my gosh.
Tend the soil, harvest the grain, to keep every day from being the same. Well, my hands have loved you every day since birth. While my feet stay planted firmly on the earth. Didn't mean to frighten you. Come out. I'm really sorry. Please. Please, Brownie. I'm so sorry. Oh. Oh. My little Brownie. I've been made a fool. You know that prince guy that was here earlier? He didn't want me. He just wanted to laugh at me and everything. And he seemed so kind and smart. And he didn't even wear any shoes, Brownie. And I even practiced my curtsy thing. No prince will ever see it. You can play my prince. Do you want to see my curtsy? Okay.
My dear Cinderella, that curtsy will leave our prince without words tonight. I'm here to help you.
Who are you?
I'm your fairy godmother.
You're my fairy godmother.
Tonight you must claim the life you were meant to live. You must be farmer and queen. From this now forward.
This is impossible, godmother.
Impossible, Cinderella.
And yet even impossible things have a way of coming true.
Well, I dreamt for a moment about working by that guy's side, but he only meant to make a joke of me.
Nonsense. He was entranced by you.
Oh, but the invitation thing?
The invitation was real, my dear. You must go to the festival.
I do so wish to go, godmother, but I don't even have a carriage or an escort, and I don't even have any shoes to wear.
3, 4, 5, Cinderella. Call your friends to our aid.
Unless you count the mice of the fields in my garden, but I don't really have any friends,
Cinderella,
godmother.
I do count them. Call them and see how much they do wish to help you.
Okay, very well. Mice of the fields, come to me now. Oh, Beatrice, I'm going to need you to use the... Brownie! Brownie, where's Brownie? Brownie? Oh, there's that little cute. Oh, my gosh, you're just so little cute. All right, Henry, Henry, Henry. There you are. Now you sit right next to Brownie. All right, we're going to need Buttercup, right? Buttercup, 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 Buttercup. Oh, there she is. Hello. All right, you go over here. Now, John. We're going to need John. John. Oh, hello, John. No, what are you doing, silly goose? Come on over here. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4. I think we're ready.
Oh. All right, tiny friends. As you carry your secrets in life, tonight you must too carry her to the royal festival. All right. Fry the chicken and cut. No. That was almost really bad.
Oh.
Stay there.
Okay.
Fry the chicken and cut the corn.
What a handsome team of horses! I shall be the luckiest girl brought to the festival by my best of friends in the world!
Carriage, pick your favorite pumpkin, Cinderella.
Her. She was my mother's favorite kind.
You're gonna want to stay back for this one.
Oh.
Fry the chicken and cut the corn. We got our carriage and our horses. We need a coachman. That sprightly rabbit go?
She won't be caught, godmother. I chase her every single day of my life, and I never catch her.
You have a magic carriage.
Uh-huh.
Horses.
Uh-huh.
And a fairy godmother.
Uh-huh.
And you want to give up because a rabbit's fast.
Right you are, godmother, but 10 bucks, she won't come. Beatrice, care for a minute of exercise? Oh, she's happy today. Oh, yeah, she's really fast.
Be simply down.
I'm gonna need you to slow up your roll.
Cinderella, my dear. For goodness sake, try asking her.
Asking her?
Asking her.
Okay. Beatrice, will you please stop running and help me?
Works every time.
Beatrice, will you please lead my beautiful carriage to the festival tonight?
Ooh. Ooh. All right, let's do this. Fry the chicken
and cut the corn.
Cinderella, I'd be honored to lead your carriage tonight. She speaks too?
Of course she speaks. She used to command your team of horses or whatever that she does.
Fairy Godmother, these are all so beautiful things, but I don't even have a dress to wear. These overalls are all I kind of got.
Cinderella, your dress is here.
This is impossible, Godmother. My mom was making something just like this when she was sick. She would sit on here and work on this dress while I tended all these pumpkins.
You may have forgotten, my dear, but your field did not.
I could never thank you enough, Godmother.
You don't need to thank me.
Can I go put it on now?
You gotta hold your horses, my dear. I have some milk for you. I almost forgot them. They were right here. Could have sworn I put them there. No. Definitely not.
Here they are. My brain.
They're fashioned from the tears you have shed on this ground. They're here to keep you connected with the earth you so love.
This prince will never recognize such a well-dressed farmer.
You better get on now. You can change in the carriage.
Okay, all right.
Okay.
Oh,
we have the dress, shoes.
Give me up.
Horses. Carriage.
Yeah.
No, wait! Oh, no. Cinderella! Oh. Cinderella. There's something else you might want to know.
Okay.
You have to be home by midnight.
So soon?
The magic ends on the last stroke of midnight. Basically, that is that again, which would not be good.
Well, see you at midnight then.
I'll see you at midnight.
Okay.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Get up. Have fun. Make good choices. I'm getting too old for this. Cleaning up after her too.
Pretty uncomfortable. Looking sharp.
Oh my goodness, I'm so grateful to be your first choice of partners, my prince.
Well, you seem rather
eager. Especially when a crown, a crowned prince is at stake.
You mentioned earlier that you lived on Poitouin de Mer. Tell me of the farm there.
What farm, sir?
The pumpkin farm on your land. The pumpkins are legendary across Africa.
Well, some people will believe anything, even if it's impossible, my prince.
What do you know of the secret farmer?
Well, she is exactly that. A secret. A stinky secret. And her stench seems to follow you. Even when you've left her behind.
Left her behind? Will she not be coming?
I believe she has declined the invitation. I suppose she prefers the company of her pumpkins to your festival.
Well, if she does not come,
then... Now, please, Peter, are we going to talk about that stinky farmer girl the entire time we dance? I shouldn't like to waste a moment with you.
Oh, no, of course not, Piper. Tell me, what do you dream of?
I think that would be quite obvious.
Thank you for the dance, maiden.
You're welcome. Splendid.
Yes. Splendid.
May I have this dance?
Silly sister. He should be the one to ask. Forgive her. He's crazy.
Not to me. I'm not taking any chances.
Listen, you don't have to accept.
Delaney.
She's brazen and quiet.
Delaney!
The most crazy. What are you doing?
Oh. Madeline, I'd love nothing more.
That's me.
So we'll start from the time I was born. I came out of my mom's body on the Midsummer's Eve, and she was really, really happy because she was finally glad to have a child with Vaughn over because my sister Pippi, she's a bit of a sourpuss, you know, you just dance with her. You know, we were just cruising along, and you know, she was like, oh, great child, yay!
Now tell me, did the prince promise you anything?
There was no time. He questioned me about Farmerella for ages. I called her stinky.
I actually used that word.
Papa, stinky or not, it is your job to make him forget about her. Someone will be earning a crown tonight, and I was under the impression that you wanted that honor. Was I mistaken?
No, of course not, Mother. Tell me what to do.
Wait a few songs and then cut in. Flatter him. If he wants to talk about farming, pretend to know. You have to do whatever it takes, Papa. Whatever it takes.
Libby hasn't stopped speaking the entire time they've been dancing. Perhaps he needs to be saved from such exhausting conversation.
Ruthless even to your sister. Papa, you may be a better queen than even I expected.
Of course. Now, Mother, go distract that pretty girl in yellow over there. She looks as though she's ready to pounce on him.
As you wish, my queen.
And then me and my sister Pimpy, we started teasing Farmerella a lot because she's spending so much time in those trumpet patches. And then she just started spending more.
Cinderella is your sister?
Well, yeah, she's the one that makes the pumpkins go, ooh, I'm a pumpkin, look at me grow.
Sorry, yeah. No, I wouldn't do it.
Your Majesty.
Lovely maiden.
Forgive for my late arrival. Took a work of magic to bring me here tonight.
All is forgiven. You're lovely, and
first time in his life.
Forgive me, maiden. May I have this dance? Forgive my stare, but surely I could not have forgotten a face as beautiful as yours. Perhaps I have seen it in my dreams.
Oh, how lovely an honor to dwell in the prince's dreams.
I believe you should dwell in my dreams from this night forward.
Oh, excuse me, my prince. I'm way too clumsy.
Prince Tadis, I was helping you.
I must go after her. Everyone, please, continue.
Oh, who is she?
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 Well, y'all heard the prince. Continue dancing. Whoever she is, I hope she stays.
Do not run from me, maiden. I have not even your name to find you.
I only run from my humiliation, prince. Not from you.
I find you endearing, stumbling when I draw too near.
I'm usually quite sure-footed.
I find myself a little unstable around you as well. Might I know your name, that I may speak a word so sweet?
You give away a part of my secret? I couldn't.
But I must know you. You're the most intriguing woman that I've
You know of me only what you see.
What I see draws me ever nearer.
If I were less beautiful, though, less adorned.
Maiden, if you would only allow me to know you, you could choose any adornment you wish.
I'm not used to these shoes.
Here. I may not know your name, maiden, but I know your heart. I know at least a part of your secret.
Part of my secret?
I know your heart quickens when I draw near.
I'm barely able to stand. I suppose a proper maiden wouldn't say such things, but the truth spills out of me before I even think about it.
Proper or not, the nearer I am, the more you enchant me. Here,
the stars up above and the earth under our feet.
We seem to have misplaced our prince, ladies and gentlemen, but we shall not let that keep us from our final celebration of the evening. As the clock approaches midnight, let us salute Prince Titus in his quest to bring prosperity back to Agricole. To the prince, long life! To the prince, long life!
What is that, Titus? Are they saluting you?
Yes, I think the king is calling for the final celebration of the evening. Must be nearing midnight.
Did you say midnight?
Yes.
I'm so sorry. I gotta go, my prince. I'm really sorry.
Ma'am.
I gotta go. I'm really sorry. Oh, excuse me, guys.
Ma'am!
Your Majesty, the king would like for you to lead the traditional midnight dance. It's your final duty tonight. You must do it now.
Yes, tell my father I shall return in a matter of minutes. I must find her.
Oh.
I will find her after search through every corner of Agricole.
My story.
I'm sure he was devastated you were interrupted, Mandolin.
He was. I was talking about Cinderella, and we were having a good old time.
You talked to the prince about Farmerella.
Why, yes, he was asking me about pumpkins.
You idiot. The only reason he wanted to dance with you because he knew that we were late somewhere and we're late to live in our house. It is okay. He hasn't chosen a bride yet, so you still have a chance.
Hear ye, hear ye! The Prince of Agricole searches now for the maiden of the land who left her shoe in his hand. Hear ye, hear ye!
Prepare yourself for a royal guest, for he will search every home in Agricole. Hear ye, hear ye!
The Prince!
The Prince! Go, Piper! Go, Mandolin, and prepare yourselves for the Prince!
Okay.
And for God's sake, not another word of Cinderella.
Okay.
Barty, have you seen Cinderella? She's not among the pumpkins. She's nowhere to be found.
No, dear. She must be off helping some sick child.
Perhaps you saw her at the festival?
I saw no farmer girl at the festival, my dear. I'm certain that she must be off somewhere.
Red Handsome Patois de Mer, prepare for a royal guest. His Majesty, the King of Agricole, wishes to address you.
Piper! Mandolin! Come down! Oh, Your Majesty!
I am looking for the owner of this shoe. I wish to speak to her.
Thank heavens, Prince Titus. I was so worried I'd have to come all the way back to the castle to get it. You wanted to speak with me?
I have many things to say to the rightful owner of this shoe, but first allow my man Delaney to place it on your foot so that I know you are she.
Of course, of course. I dearly love this pair of shoes. I've had them for so long.
I wear them all the time, and they just fit me like a glove.
You're not trying hard enough.
My head, it must have got foot trauma. Sometimes I'm from the dance.
That'll be enough, young maiden.
Really?
May I try? My foot's a lot smaller and daintier than Pippi's.
Are there no other eligible young women in your home?
Well, you're high.
I'm not a single one, Your Majesty!
Very well. Thank you for your time.
Bye-bye.
Oh,
come back down here. Okay.
Your Highness, you...
Yes, dear sir, what is it?
My daughter, Prince Titus.
Yes, I have seen both of them, dear sir.
Darling, you know that I just told the prince...
I have another daughter, Cinderella.
Where is she? Why did she not present herself?
She's not here, Your Majesty. She's away on a trip.
She is gone. Very far away.
Bye-bye.
Very far.
Must go away.
Bye.
I am here, my prince.
My secret farmer.
Oh, Prince Titus. You swore to try the shoe on every girl in the kingdom.
Very well. But I know how this one feels about wearing shoes.
Prince Titus?
It fits! The shoe fits!
Indeed it does, but just as uncomfortable as last night.
Oh!
Farmer and maiden in one woman! How could I be so blind? Impossible.
Impossible, maybe, but true nevertheless.
Delaney, get them out of here! What are you doing?
Come on, Pickle.
I have something to ask you.
Yes, Titus. I'll share my pumpkins with your royal farm.
That is wonderful news, but that is not what I wanted to ask. Cinderella, will you marry me?
Yes, Titus. Yes, I will marry you.
To His Majesty, the future King of Agricole.
Allow me to introduce my future bride, holder of my heart, and teacher of my people, your future queen, Cinderella.
Good people of Agricole, I hereby decree shoes will no longer be required at royal functions. Join me and feel the soft grass under your feet and the dirt hot between your toes. We are a people of the land, the magical earth of Agricole. Mandolin, join me in removing those shoes of yours.
Well, I'll try, but I know I'm not gonna.
Mother! What a feeling!
All right, Bill, I'll try. Okay. Stop begging.
Oh. Oh, my. I've never felt so...
Cinderella. I get it. That's what you... Mother. It's so nice. Go try it. Go.
Just try it. You might like it. Yum. Yum.
Fine. But I don't see what all of the fuss is about. Oh. Oh, what a magical feeling. Oh, it's
wonderful and cool. Oh, I haven't felt this way since I was a girl. Oh, what a magical feeling!
Magical indeed! Come, my friends, step into a new life and a new kingdom as we join our hearts together in marriage. Together we serve.
Together we love.
Together we will find a way.
My king.
My queen.
Hooray!